T.N. Gnaneshwaran, working as Assistant Professor of English at Government First Grade College. I would like to introduce an English play, The Way of the World, written by Miriam Congreve. Miriam Congreve was born in England in 1670. He studied at the Trinity College in Dublin. He wrote four comedies, namely The Old Bachelor, The Double Dealer, Love for Love, and The Way of the World. The Way of the World, written in 1700, is his masterpiece. He died in London in 1729 and was buried in Westminster. The play, The Way of the World, is a restoration comedy in general and a comedy of manners in particular. The restoration period begins in 1660, the year in which King Charles II was restored to the English throne. A comedy of manners is the comic or satiric representation of aristocratic sexual license. A comedy of manners is usually unsentimental, cynical, and immoral. There will be a scandal or the threat of scandal in a comedy of manners. Oscar Wilde and William Congreve are the most celebrated authors of comedy of manners. Now, I shall introduce the characters in this play. Mirabel is the protagonist in this play. He is a young man. He is in love with Melamed. Melamed is a very charming young lady. She is niece to Lady Wishfort and she is in love with Mirabel. Fainall is a friend of Mirabel. He married the daughter of Lady Wishfort for her money, but he is in love with Mrs. Margot. Mrs. Fainall is wife of Fainall and daughter of Lady Wishfort. Mrs. Margot is the mistress of Fainall, but she loves Mirabel. Lady Wishfort is a widow. She is the guardian of Melamed and mother of Mrs. Fainall. At the age of 55, now she wants to marry Sir Roland, an uncle of Mirabel. Sir Wilfrid Whitwood is a nephew of Lady Wishfort and her choice as a suitor for Melamed. Young Whitwood is Sir Whitwood's younger brother. Wakefield is Mirabel's servant. Fainall is Lady Wishfort's maid. Peppermint is Whitwood's friend. Mincing is Melamed's maid. Pet is a maid in Lady Wishfort's house. Now let me tell you an overview of the play. The play is based around two lovers, Mirabel and Melamed. To receive Melamed's full dowry, Mirabel must receive the blessing of Melamed's aunt, Lady Wishfort. Unfortunately, Lady Wishfort despises Mirabel and wants her nephew Sir Wilfrid to wed Melamed. Meanwhile, Lady Wishfort, a widow, wants to marry again and has her eyes on an uncle of Mirabel's, the wealthy Sir Roland. Venchwell pretends to be Sir Roland and on Venable's command tries to trick Lady Wishfort into a false engagement. Lady Wishfort offers Mirabel her consent to the marriage if he can save her fortune and honor. Now let us discuss the play in detail. To understand the play, we should know some of the developments which have occurred before the play begins. Arabella's first husband Langwish has died and left over his fortune. She begins a secret affair with Mirabel. They end the affair and she gets married to a man Mirabel has selected, that is Fainall. Mirabel begins courting Mrs. Fainall's cousin Willamant, who lives with her aunt Lady Wishfort. To gain Wishfort's favor, Mirabel flatters Wishfort. Wishfort becomes convinced that he loves her after Wishfort's friend Mrs. Marwood reveals what Mirabel was up to. Her feelings change from love to hate. She denies permission for Mirabel to marry Millamant. If she will not consent to the marriage, Mirabel cannot get Millamant's £6,000 dowry. Act 1 is set in a chocolate house where Mirabel and Fainall have just finished playing cards. A footman tells Mirabel that Waitwell and Fainall were married that morning. Then Witwood and Petulant appear and inform Mirabel that he will only get £6,000 of Millamant's inheritance if he can make Lady Wishfort consent to his son Millamant's marriage. Act 2 is set in St. James Park. Mrs. Fainall and Mrs. Marwood are discussing their hatred of men. Fainall appears and accuses Mrs. Marwood of loving Mirabel. Meanwhile, Mrs. Fainall and Mirabel begin to plot about tricking Lady Wishfort to give her consent to the marriage. Then Millamant appears in the park. She is angry about the previous night's Mirabel's encounter with Lady Wishfort. After she leaves, newlywed servants appear and Mirabel reminds them of their roles in the plan. Act 3 is set in Lady Wishfort's home. Lady Wishfort is encouraged to marry Sir Roland by Fainall. Here Sir Roland is Waitwell in disguise. Waitwell is a servant while Lady Wishfort is an aristocrat. Besides, Waitwell is already married. It would be a bigamy, not to mention a social disgrace. Mirabel offers to help her out of the embarrassing situation if she consents to his marriage. Later, Mrs. Fainall discusses this plan with Fainall, but this is overheard by Mrs. Marwood. She later tells this to Fainall, who decides that he will take his wife's money and go away with Mrs. Marwood. Act 4 is also set in Lady Wishfort's home. Mirabel and Millamant discuss in detail the conditions under which they would accept each other. Mirabel finally proposes to Millamant and Millamant accepts. Mirabel leaves as Lady Wishfort arrives. She tells that she wants Millamant to marry her nephew Sir Wilful Witwood. Later, Lady Wishfort gets a letter about the Sir Roland plant. Act 5 is also set in Lady Wishfort's home. Final uses the information of Mrs. Fineheart's previous affair with Mirabel and Millamant's contract to marry him to blackmail Lady Wishfort, telling that she should never marry and that she is to transfer all the money over to him. Lady Wishfort tells Mirabel that she will consent his marriage if he can save her fortune and honor. Now Wakefield brings a contract from the time before the marriage of the Fineheart in which Mrs. Fineheart gives all her property to Mirabel. Fineheart is left with no claim to make and Lady Wishfort consents to the marriage of Mirabel with Millamant. This is the end of the play. Now let us discuss the major themes in the play The Way of the World. First of all, marriage. Three couples marry in this play. Fineheart marries the daughter of Lady Wishfort before the play begins. The servants marry in the first act. Mirabel gets consent of Lady Wishfort to marry Millamant at the end of the play. Next theme is true love versus fake love. Only the love of Mirabel and Millamant is true love. The love between other pairs is fake. The next theme is accumulation of property through marriage. Fineheart marries the daughter of Lady Wishfort for money. Even Mirabel wants to get consent of Lady Wishfort to marry Millamant to get the dowry. The next theme is appetite for sex and money. Lady Wishfort, even at the age of 55, wants to marry again. Most of the characters have an illicit affair. Mirabel and Fineheart devise plot and counterplot to claim the inheritance of Millamant. The next theme is deceit. In this play, everyone tries to deceive the other. None of the relationships are trusting. Next thing is social class. We see two main classes in the play, upper class and servants. Upper class characters try to maintain status and reputation in the society. Next thing is pretense and hypocrisy. Hypocrisy is the hallmark of upper class characters in this play. Next thing is vanity. We see vanity in Lady Wishfort and Mrs. Marwood.